Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing a video. We're going to be doing another reaction video. I know you guys have been asking about this video a lot, so I'm just gonna do it and get it out of the way. I've just been really sick lately and dealing with a lot of shit, so I haven't had time to really like do anything, and I haven't really felt good, but we're gonna do this. And if you like my little setup, whatever, it's about to be Christmas, but whatever. Let's get into this, because we're gonna be doing a Kissland reaction. Anyways, so let me react to Kissland. I know that I'm a loser. I've never listened to this album before, Kissland. I know I'm a stupid bitch.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I've never listened to this, and I promise that I suck. I know I suck. I've never listened to it. Loser, but you know what? We're getting into this shit right now. Okay? Anyways, so the first song on the album is called Professional. So let's do it. Got my speaker ready. Let's do this shit. Okay, I think in the beginning I was kind of thinking that he was talking about like how he's like gotten successful or whatever the fuck, but it's definitely, I feel like he's talking about how people are nowadays, like loving and emotional versus non-emotional, like numb, kind of like just like more technical with relationships. Instead of being emotional, you're detached in a sense, and I think he's calling that professional, and I think that's what this is about. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that's kind of what I'm getting.
Like it's personal, no, cause it's just love. It always makes its way back around.
Okay, the way he's talking about relationships and love in general is such an Aquarian vibe. He's an Aquarius, and Aquarians are more emotionally detached in a sense. So when he's saying that, you know, it's just love, it always comes back around, it's disposable in a sense, then he's basically categorizing it as, you know, something that's temporary. And that's what a lot of Aquarians feel love is. They don't really get attached emotionally in that sense. I mean, they do, but when they do and things end, they go through their natural grieving process, but they always remind themselves, like, this is just temporary in a sense, and that'll always get it back. So I kind of get that from this song.
It's dispensable to fall into uncertain, cause everything you've been through made you stronger, and every day you learn about yourself, and nothing really played out how it's supposed to, depending on somebody else as well.
Oh, I love you.
only holding your own. Girl, you've got it ready. Are you blaming? Cause the freedom was here in this cage all along. Oh, how do you drain all the soul from your eyes? How do you teach yourself how to smile? In a world where your dreams can't be real, no, every touch that you sound is alive.
All those nights you were up early holding your own, girl, you've got it made. Had you blaming yourself all when life did you wrong? Now you've got it made, getting rich to the drums of your favorite song. Girl, you've got it made, cause your freedom was here in this cage all along. How did you drain all the soul from your eyes? How did you teach yourself how to smile in a world where your dreams can't be real? No, every touch that you sell is a lie. That's deep as fuck. Oh my god. Why is that me? No, I'm not. Anyways, let's keep going. This song's really cute so far. I really like it. Song was really cute. That was called The Professional. Now we're gonna go to track number two, Tears in the Rain. I'm just kidding. Now we're gonna go to track number two, The Town. Bitch, let's go. Sorry, it's giving me creepy vibes. It's like so like
you did many things that I liked, and you like that moment. I can provide for you. It made me feel so good.
I'm reading the lyrics, so I'm sorry if I keep looking down. When the sun goes up, you're searching for love, so your heart won't lead you to anyone. When the sun goes down, I know what you become. You become awake, unlike the rest of us. Okay, let's see where else we can go.
Oh.
Talking about what everybody fucking goes through, right? There's these two things that we are promoted in our society: marriage, relationship, children, all that good stuff, and just being a free bird. You know, there's always a choice between having the freedom to do whatever you want, sleep with as many people as you want. You know, it's everybody calls it the lie, because although that's marketed to us as like the funnest and most fulfilling times of our lives, some people would argue that you're empty the whole time. But that's just some people. I feel like if you have a good mental health and you're doing everything you want to genuinely do for all the right reasons and you're being a good person, I don't really think that that lifestyle is technically a lie. But the way he's talking about it, it is, because he's empty inside. He's using people, they're using him. There's drugs and alcohol involved. He's a star. All those, you know, all that shit is just laid out right in front of him with all the money. And then there's this one bitch that he really cares about. What is he gonna choose, right? What's marketed to him as like the funnest time of his life in his 20s that he could experience, or some girl that he has feelings for? So he's obviously choosing the lifestyle. Also, like, the fact that he says that's okay, I adapted anyway, it's like, as human beings, we are really resilient. And once you can like be completely obliterated by a situation, but you know, time heals all wounds. And he's just being like, I'll miss your face or whatever, but that's okay, because I adapted anyway. You know, like, I'm good now, I've moved on. Even though I'll always miss you, like, I'm fine, like, it's not gonna affect my daily life. So the next song we're gonna go to is Love in the Sky. There's a lot going on with the drums and shit, like, it's making me wanna dance. Okay.
If you committed this right, there's no turning back. You've been here, this world's not for us. It's not what it seemed. You'll burn to the habit.
Cute.
would have left, but that pussy in control. Got the pussy in control. I got it in control.
I mean, if he could only slow down, maybe he'd be in love. Maybe he could feel everything, you know, even sexually. Damn. That song was so good. Okay, let's go to the next track. Next is Belong to the World. Okay, so what he's saying, like I told you, like he's saying that he fucking, wait, let me read the lyrics. The way you doubt your feelings and look the other way, well, it's something I relate to. Your gift of nonchalance. Nobody's ever made me fall in love with this amount of touch. So he's basically like, that's that, like what I'm talking about. Like, he may feel, but he ignores the feelings. Like, he rejects them. He doesn't want them. Because that's like the nonchalance. Like, for me, for instance, I can even relate to that because I could feel a lot for somebody, but I'm gonna act like I don't.
Stop it. Get some help.
Because the detachment, like the whole essence of that, the whole essence of feeling for somebody and being vulnerable in that sense to the person that you're feeling for is like nauseating for me. It's probably nauseating for him. It's something that's scary for people. Some people, for Aquarians, what I'm relating it to, like, I might feel so fucking much for somebody, but they won't know that because I'm gonna pretend that I don't.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Because, I don't know, it's just, we just pretend like we don't because it's scary to be that fucking vulnerable. But anyway, let's keep going. I'm not so mistreat you? That's fucked up. I'm sorry, my sister is in the background. It's hard to react.
Hopelessly devoted to you.
Anyways, so. Ooh, girl, I know I should leave you and learn to mistreat you. Cause you belong to the world. And ooh, girl, I want to embrace you, domesticate you, but you belong to the world. You belong to the world. It's kind of like the way we say on Twitter, like, they belong to the streets type of shit. Like, I feel like that's what he's talking about. Like, you belong to everybody. You know, that person that belongs to no one but belongs to everyone. Who wants nothing but wants everything. Who has nothing but wants everything. Lana Del Rey. People that are the other woman. People that are the other man. The people that belong to the streets. The people that are called whores or homewreckers or whatever the fuck. The ones that are heartless. Or they feel but they don't like to fucking show that they feel, so they're considered heartless. That's what he's talking about. I don't know about the mistreat you, but he's probably like, I don't want to coddle you because you don't want to coddle me type of thing. If you want to pretend like you don't give a fuck about, or not even pretend, like maybe you don't give a fuck about me. Maybe he thinks she really doesn't give a fuck about him. So he's like, okay, you don't give a fuck about me. I have to pretend like I don't give a fuck about you. I wish I could not give a fuck about you in general. Right? We always want what we can't have. But anyways, he's basically saying that. That's what I'm getting. that so fucking much. You put so much in and hold on so fucking tight because you know that it's gonna end. Like, that's literally me with everybody that I've ever been with.
You suck!
It's because it's so unsure. So, like, you put your all into it because you're like, fuck it. Like, while it lasts, like, I want to enjoy it. So, I'm going to go fucking all in. And that's kind of how I am. So, I get that. Like, you're just going with the flow until you, and you know it's going to end. So, you're just going with the flow until it fucking ends abruptly. And you're just going to be left in shambles. But, yeah, I completely relate with that fucking line.
Me smile in circles. I succumb to what I've become.
Okay, so just even in his album cover, that side eye he's giving, it's like the acknowledgement of somebody that's similar to you. Like, that just subtle relatability, like you guys recognize yourself in one another type of shit. Like, he's falling for her because she's dead inside. He can see himself in her. He understands her. That's something that's scary, because if you can relate to somebody to that extent, it usually doesn't end well. People that are similar to you, especially if you're not in like a good headspace, that's fucking toxic. And you're just basically feeding each other the same fucking medicine that you're giving, that you're getting. So you're just like, it's just this battle. But like, yeah, I can completely fucking relate to this song. He wants to do all these. I feel like even if he want, like, he wants to do all these things with her, he wants to domesticate all this stuff. Sorry, my fucking legs are falling asleep. Once he does that, like, the fact that he's saying, but you belong to the world, I'm getting this feeling that it's like he appreciates her nature, right? So he doesn't, like, he wants to domesticate her, he wants to make her his. But he's like so appreciative of her nature that it's like he doesn't want to take that away. He doesn't want to take that magic away. He fell for her for a reason.
You belong to the world. You belong to the world.
Those lines are so fucking beautiful, and they're so particular in this song. You belong to the loneliness of feeling every need. You belong to the world. You belong to the world. You belong to the temporary moments of a dream. That is so true. It's like they're not, you're not falling in love with that person. You don't even know them. She most likely, those are just defense mechanisms that she's developed, right? You're falling in love with this idea of a person. Will that ever work out? Probably fucking not. But the fact that he's saying that, you belong to the temporary moments of a dream, you belong to the loneliness of feeling every need, he's recognizing that nature in her that's in himself, that is temporary, that's elusive, that is lonely and voidful and destructive and empty. It's a facade. It's a facade, right? He can't have her. He can't domesticate her. She belongs to the world. And that's just such a good fucking, just ending, like, it beautiful. I fucking love this song. Like, it's just, it encapsulates the essence of everything that's been spoken of in this song in those three fucking lines. It's perfect, for sure.
And
The next song on the album is Live For by The Weeknd featuring Drake. So we're gonna go into that one. But anyways, Belong to the World so far has been my favorite on this album. Sorry, not sorry. Let's go. OVO and EXO, that's all you believe in. Or that's everything you believe in, or whatever the fuck. Are they still beefing, or are they cool now? Somebody let me know.
Getting sober for a day, got me feeling too low. They're trying to make me slow down, trying to tell me how to live. I'm about to lose control.
Lose control.
Sitting in the bed scene. This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I live for. With the people I live for. This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I live for. With the people I live for.
What this reminds me of? This reminds me of like hood shit. Like, you know, I don't know like if you guys can relate, but I came up, I grew up poor, like broke, like my mom's ratchet, you know, like, not ratchet, but she's not, you know what I'm saying? She's from the Bay. Anyways, but like that you live for, that fucking hood ass, fun ass, party ass shit, like, with your family, like, with the people you die for, like, fucking, like, with the oven open because you can't afford the motherfucking heater in the middle of the winter celebrating New Year's, like, with popping bottles and shit, everybody's fucked up, people are fighting, all that shit, like, I would do anything to go back and relive those moments, even though they were chaotic. And even I go through now, you know, when I go back home, but it's just the shit you live for. Like, it's fun as fuck. Like, you grew up in that environment. Like, you're comfortable. It's your element. I don't know. But that's the vibe I'm getting now, right now.
Shit that I live for, this is shit that I die for, this shit you can't fake though, this is shit you need God for. How long do you think it's gonna take for y'all to fall? That's a serious question, cause I seriously question all of y'all. Things I shouldn't share, I mean for the sake of my career. I'm not trying to stunt, I'm just telling you the truth, I swear. This the shit that I live for, with the people I die for. This is shit you can't fake, dog. This is shit you need God for. This that shit we really gotta talk about in person. There's some shit I need to work on, but I know you see me working, nigga.
This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I live for. With the people I die for. This is shit that I live for. This is shit.
I mean, I liked his verse.
This is shit that I live for.
They're definitely talking about money, drugs, and bitches, like, and friends. Like, they're not talking about what I was talking about. But, like, in a sense, when I'm thinking about what I live for, like, with the people I die for, it's, like, cutting up with your fucking family, like. Track number 7, Wanderlust. Wanderlust. Oh my gosh. Okay. Shit. Let's go. And burn a hole into your apprehensiveness and let wildfire shine. And repeat after me, good girls go to heaven and bad girls go everywhere. And tonight I will love you and tomorrow you won't care. True. You're in love with something bigger than love. You believe in something stronger than trust. Wanderlust, wanderlust. Why the fuck is that me?
When you think about
it, he's always about the, like, just... He's always about talking about the night. Like, he's like, tomorrow you won't care, but you know what, bitch? Tonight, we finna get crazy and wild and have the time of our lives together, because we're in wanderlust, bitch. We're in fucking wanderlust. So who gives a fuck about tomorrow, and who gives a fuck about the future? It's the now. So take your motherfucking clothes off and let's get popping, bitch. Like, that's his vibe and I fuck with it. Like, there would be no way in hell like he would ever be able to deal with me, because I would be hooked on this motherfucker, because we'd be the same fucking person.
Cause I'll be there for him with open arms and open legs and an open mouth.
And I'd be like drawn to that vibe. I need to, like, I'm working on it, okay? I'm not trying to just be attracted to people that are fleeting, but shit, the chase is just so desirable. I don't know.
Stop it. Get some help.
But anyways, let's keep going. Precious little diamond, I'll leave it all to you, like, in the little, I can kind of hear it in the little chorus or whatever the fuck. It kind of sounds like he did in Trilogy, like, when he, I don't know if that's him, like, pitching his voice up and shit, like, that one song, Bird, the Birds Part 2 or something like that. That really creeped me out, but, like, that's kind of what I'm getting so far. Such a good fucking time, bro. Like, imagine going on a date with him. Like, I don't even give a fuck about the future or the past, but just live in the now type of shit. Oh my god, that'd be such a good ass time. Wanderlust, I just think about sparkles
pussy.
And shit. Lindsay, shut the fuck up.
When he says wanderlust, I think about pussy.
Lindsay, stop.
She wanna fuck with a woo.
And this word, it just epitomizes it, because it's wanderlust, like wandering, wander. Like, it comes, it goes everywhere, and lust. So it's this idea of love that's very, you know, fleeting. It's consuming and fleeting at the same time. It's just here, there, it's everywhere. So that word just completely epitomizes that feeling, and I fucking love it. That song was so cute, but you know, like, in Scary Movie, when they're, like, doing the basketball scene, they're, like, dribbling and shit? Like, that's just how I feel like I am. Camera. They're, like, dribbling the fucking balls, and they're just, like,
bitch. Pikey, pikey, who can touch? You can play.
Shut the fuck up.
You can say, I'm always yours.
Ah! The next song is Kiss Land.
Life is your...
Which is the name of the fucking album, so let's get this shit. Let's get this shit, Kiss Land, bitch. Let's go. Okay, futuristic sounds. Oh shit. Screaming some serial killer shit.
When I got on stage, she swore I was 6 feet tall. But when she put it in her mouth, she can't seem to reach mine.
What?
Ballin' ain't an issue for me. I'm sex right back next week and do it all again. Feeding up the wrong thing, the wrong thing. And I'll admit, baby, I'm a little camera shy. But exceptions can make babies, cause you're too damn fly. For what it's worth, I hope you enjoy the show. Cause if you're back here only taking pictures, you're gonna have to take your ass off. Cause the only thing you're taking is your clothes off.
I guess I am.
Go ahead, girl, strip it down, yeah. Close your mouth, I just wanna hear your body talk.
Oh, oh shit! Did he dead ass put those noises in there? I just wanna hear your body talk, bro. What the fuck? Why are we the same person? I just don't understand. Why? Why is he so relatable to me?
In the room where the kisses ain't free, you gotta pay with your body. I'm really into kisses leading into nothing. I'm into shows every night. If you play your cards right, I might fuck around, bring your whole crew on tour. Fuck around, turn it to my West Coast girl until they book a show in NYC. Gotta fly back east where the city don't sleep. Oh, I'm trying to finish all this potion. Baby, take your time. I'm trying to sip it till the morning. And if you're still up, I'm trying to fuck you in the morning. Said I'm 2 days strong and never sleep until it's morning. Until the morning. Cause the only thing you're taking is your clothes off. Go ahead, girl, strip it down, close your mouth, I just wanna hear your body talk. Whoa. Ooh, yeah. Don't hold back, let it out.
Why is that the bottom doing right now? I'm gonna fucking sing. This is what I look like at clubs. This is why people are mocking me. Why the fuck can I relate to that? Dude, his album cover in general is just like the fucking side eye, bro. Like, you know what's up, bitch. Like, you trying to fuck or suck or what? Or nah. That fucking song. Anyways, let's keep going.
My niggas round him up and probably not if we take him to my spot. And probably not if I tweak all day just to sleep at night. Goddamn, I'm high. My doctor told me to stop. And he gave me some antipop. Now mix it up with some Adderalls and I'll wait to get to the top. Now mix it up with some alcohol and I'll pull it up in a shot. I don't care about you. Why you worry about me? All I want is that smoke. Give me all of that smoke. Last week was my rough week. I'm still dripping down from my nose. And I don't know how to drive. I make my driver get high. But if he goes under that 110, believe my driver get fired. And I don't.
got any friends. Got ex on my boy, bro, she's a tongue twist. I like the feeling your tongue rings. She liked the way my whole tongue flip. She grind hard for tuition. She grind hard to her teacher. I make her hotter with gold grills. I make her sucker with gold grills. In the back room of the VIP, she don't know this thing.
Say nothing to relate. Hella dope. That verse was hella nice. Okay, let's keep going. Yeah, I bet, I don't know, but like, to relate to all that, like, damn. Like, the amount of drugs and alcohol, like, holy shit. I can't relate to that shit. I would have been laid the fuck out. I would have been in the hospital getting a stomach pump, getting a fucking, you know, IV up all up in my veins, bitch. Like, I would have been gone if I did that shit. Like, fuck, like, two shots, I'm already blackout drunk, falling on the pavement, bitch. Like, no. The next song on the album. The second to last song on the fucking album is Pretty. Let's go. Why do I feel like this is the shortest album of his? But let's fucking go, bitch.
Somebody told me it was pointless for me to come back into your arms. Said you fucked another
man. That fucking like western ass vibe in the background. What the fuck is that? It's so good.
Cause I see fear in your eyes. You've been living out your life. As long as you know that when I land your mind.
Just the way he created this song in a sense that gives me nostalgic vibes. It's giving me like, let's go back into the past. Like, that's just what I'm getting right now. And the way he fucking encapsulates that vibe is just insane to me. Like, I know where he's taking us.
As long as you know that when I land your mind, and you will never feel so pretty. You will never feel this beautiful when I make it there. When I make it there.
Yeah.
song on Kissland, and it is called Tears in the Rain, bitch. So let's get this show on the fucking road and let's get this party fucking started, bitch. Because this is the last motherfucking song on Kissland and I'm so excited to hear it. Intro makes me feel like I'm in a psychological thriller, like when they're walking into the fucking mental. I don't know. Like a scary little people vibe. Okay, so those lyrics are just telling me. He said, when it's said and done, I already felt love, and I let it end up dying by itself. Like self-sabotage shit, you know, you don't think you deserve it, so you ruin it before the other person can hurt you type of shit. You don't think you deserve them, you think they're better than you. You deserve real love, but I deserve to be it by myself. That's so fucking sad. He probably treats her like shit too. And he actually likes her a lot. Because he doesn't want her to know that that's how he feels.
Cause I've gone too far, and I started too young to give up. And even if I changed, it would be too late. I exposed my voice. Now every girl I see,
I feel the same.
Like melancholy, but it's also like something that you would get fucking, you'd freak a leak to. I don't know what the vibe is giving me, but it's like get down, like in reminiscent vibes, like kind of sexual, but at the same time sad. That's literally what I'm getting from this. Just like the song, one of the songs in After Hours, where he's like, I should have let you go, but I'm not going to let you go type of shit. He's saying he could have watched her leave. He could have let her ass go, but he's selfish. Like every man ever. I should have let you leave, but I let you watch me slip away. I could have set you free. But I'm selfish. I watched you stay. It's fucked up. That's so fucking sad. Chorus is basically like explaining how toxic the relationship was to the point where she forgot who she was before she met him, and she forgot how good he was in the beginning and the nice things about him. All she sees is the evil, and she's hooked on the evil, and she's probably fucking tormented and miserable because she's so fucking sad, because not only did he watch her stay, but she has to watch him slip away. Oh, god damn, this is so fucking sad. Okay, that was Tears in the Rain, and that was the last song on Kissland. I really like that song. It was so fucking sad. Like, obviously, it just epitomizes everything, you know? It just epitomizes everything he sings about. Regret, sex, lust, love, you know, just misery, you know, betrayal, all that shit. And he's basically, you know, explaining a toxic relationship that he caused. Now he's sitting here, as he's famous, being like, no one's ever gonna love me like her. No one knows me like her. She knows all the parts of me, not the fake parts, not all that bullshit. She knows me. And I let it slip away. Because he wanted the fame. And now he's saying just adapt to it. Because everybody's the same, so there's no fucking point. And just accept what comes or whatever. But while he's getting all that, hopefully she's building herself up. But as he describes it, like, she's just tormented by the thoughts of him that are only bad, which completely sucks. And it's so sad, and it's a really sad foot to leave off on for this album, but it was an amazing song. His voice was fucking perfect, like always. And I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Thank you so much for watching this video. I wish you guys a holly jolly, merry, merry Christmas. Be careful out there, be safe out there, stay the fuck inside your motherfucking house before I come to your motherfucking house with my mask on and beat the shit out of you for not following protocol. Get your ass the fucking bed. And if you work, please be safe. God bless you. God bless your soul. God bless your families. I hope all of you guys are having wonderful lives and are fucking growing and understanding the world and becoming better people for the future, for yourselves and for everybody around you. And yeah, so just let me know what you think. I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. God loves you guys. Now let's change lives today. Thank you.